Today on Mike Attempts, repairing a stand mixer. The previous owner said this mixer loses power and makes a grinding noise under load. Before plugging it in, I checked to be sure the power cord wasn't damaged. Well, the motor works, but it sounds rough. Let's see what's going on inside. A single screw secures the metal band. Four more and the top lifts off. The plastic transmission housing is badly cracked. Be careful when removing the left rear screw. You don't want to damage the control board. Gently lift the housing off while avoiding the ribbon cable. Everything's covered in so much dark grease that at first, it's hard to see the damage. But the grease is shining with metal grit, and that's never a good sign. The worm gear lifts right out. The beveled gear is held in place with this snap ring. A pair of snap ring pliers spreads the ring so it can be removed. Now the beveled gear can be pulled off the shaft. After pulling out the pin, use a rubber mallet to tap the shaft down. The worm follower gear is now free and can be lifted out. Time to clean out the old grease. I really like using wooden chopsticks and grill skewers for jobs like this. You can get into all the little nooks and crannies without fear of scratching anything. I won't be reusing this transmission housing, but if yours is still in one piece, you'll want to clean it out. To remove the attachment gear, just push it out with your finger. Once everything is clean, the damage is obvious. The teeth on the worm gear are severely chewed up in two areas. And one side of the front sleeve bearing flange broke completely off. I found the missing pieces buried in the grease. The beveled gear has a small shiny spot on the edge of each tooth, but there's not any damage, so I decided to reuse it. I probably overdid it a bit while cleaning, but I wanted to be sure I got all of the metal shavings. The transmission housing has two guide pins, which go in these holes. One of the pins broke off inside, so we'll need to coax it out. I got an upgraded metal transmission housing, a new gasket, worm gear, and front sleeve bearing. I also picked up 3 ounces of high quality food grade grease. I started by putting just a little grease between the teeth of the large ring gear. I did the same with the smaller gear, lubed up the shaft, and slid it up through the hole. Be sure the pin is sticking out equally on either side of the shaft and that the raised section on top of the worm follower gear is in line with the pin. The underside of the beveled gear is recessed and it won't fit any other way. When reinstalling the snap ring, be sure it's fully seated in the groove. Before greasing the new worm gear, here's how all the pieces go together. The thrust bearing goes on first and is sandwiched between two washers. Each washer has a concave track on one side, which needs to face the bearing. The rear sleeve bearing has a raised collar after the flange and goes on the back. The front sleeve bearing is flush with the flange, which goes against the thrust bearing. Squirt in some grease where the worm gear will sit. Be sure the flats of the sleeve bearings are vertical. Add some more grease on top of the worm gear. There's adhesive on one side of the new gasket. Peel off the film and stick it on the new transmission housing. Rub a thin layer of grease on the gasket. Grease up the attachment gear and pop it in the housing. Use the rest of the grease on the inside. Carefully maneuver the transmission housing into place and secure it with the four screws. Reinstall the top. Secure the metal band, and you're done. Sounds much better. Feel free to rate this video, add your comments and questions below, and subscribe for more.